क्लास 10 केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर 1। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सी द रेस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड आयनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी, इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी एंड टुडे वी विल सी इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी। सो ओपन पेज नंबर 13। सो हियर इन द बॉक्स यू कैन सी व्हाट इज दिस इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी। The tendency of an atom in a molecule to attract the shared pair of electrons towards itself is called its electronegativity. Let us see this concept by drawing a structure. This is hydrogen and this is chlorine. So altogether, which molecule is this one? This is HCl molecule. Okay. Now hydrogen is having one electron in its valence shell and chlorine, it is having 7 electrons in its valence shell. So only the valence electrons I am showing. Now in order to complete the octet for this chlorine and duplet for this hydrogen, they will share these electrons. Okay. But the sharing will not be 50-50%. Means these two electrons, although they have been shown to be shared by hydrogen and chlorine, but in reality the electronic cloud will be more towards this chlorine atom. Let me show you by drawing another structure. So here what we can see that the electronic cloud is more towards the chlorine. That means the shared pair of electron will be more towards the chlorine side. Okay, so we can say that chlorine is more electronegative since it has the tendency to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself. Got this? Now one more property about electronegativity is that it is a dimensionless property. Means it is shown by the numerical value only, but no unit it is having. Now students, do you know which element is most electronegative in the whole periodic table? It is fluorine, and a value of 4 has been given for this fluorine. You can see on the right hand side, fluorine has got 4 as the electronegativity. Now electronegativity values too depend on size of atom and nuclear charge. The smaller is the atomic size, the more will be the electronegativity, and more will be the nuclear charge, more will be the electronegativity. So along a period the electronegativity increases, and down the group the electronegativity decreases. You know, along the period the size gets decreased and down the group the size gets increased. So in general we can formulate that metals have less electronegativity and non-metals have more electronegativity. Now let us see this box on page number 14, left hand column, that is diagonal relationship. Now what does it mean, diagonal relationship? Students, in mathematics, in geometry, you know what is diagonal. That means opposite sides or opposite corners. Likewise, we have certain elements with similar properties, and the basis of these properties is the diagonal relationship. Here you can see that period second and in period third, some of the properties of lithium matches with magnesium. Then some properties for beryllium, they matches with aluminium. Some property of boron, it match with silicon. So here we can see that lithium and magnesium, they have diagonal relationship. So this is diagonal. Okay, likewise beryllium and aluminium. Now here no aluminium is there, but the aluminium is here. So this is also a diagonal relationship. In the same way, boron has a diagonal relationship with silicon. Okay, but these diagonal relationship, they does not mean that every element they will show the diagonal relationship. It is not necessary, students. So the examples are for this diagonal relationship: lithium with magnesium, beryllium with aluminium, and boron with silicon. Now come to page number 15, atomic number. Now all these topics, atomic number, mass number or atomic mass, you are already familiar with. You have already taken them in class 9. So what is this atomic number? The atomic number of an element is equal to the number of protons in the nucleus. You know, every element is having a nucleus, and this nucleus, it is having certain number of protons. So the number of protons means we will assign it to be the atomic number. This atomic number is represented by this capital Z, and this Z, that is atomic number, it is equal to number of protons, as already been stated. And we know that number of protons is equal to number of electrons also in an atom. Mass number. The mass number of an element is the sum of the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus of the atom of that element. So basically, mass number is atomic mass, means the weight of an atom. And an atom is having which subspecies? Electrons, protons and neutrons. So mass of an atom is equivalent to mass of neutrons plus mass of protons plus mass of electrons. But since mass of electrons, it is very negligible, so we consider only the mass of the protons and mass of neutrons only. So mass number is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Since mass of neutron and proton, they have been taken as a unity, so that's why mass of one proton has been or is equivalent to number of protons. Mass of neutron is equivalent to number of neutron. Let us see how these mass number and atomic number, they are represented. For example, if we take the example of sodium, so mass number will be written as subscript. We know, atomic number will be written as subscript, and mass number will be written as superscript. Okay. So I can write mass number 23, and this is also atomic mass. Okay. Then we have atomic number 11 in this case. And what is the number of neutrons? Number of neutrons. Now we know in sodium, number of protons, because we know number of protons is equal to atomic number, and number of protons is equal to number of electrons, so it is also the same. That is number of electrons, here it is 11, number of protons, here it is 11. But what about number of neutrons? So number of neutrons will be mass number minus atomic number. So 23 minus 11, that comes out to be what? 12. Now come to page number 16. A small information is there in the form of note. Elements with n upon p, that is number of neutrons upon number of protons, this ratio, if it is coming somewhere equal to 1, then such elements are stable. Okay. Then this second point, elements with the n upon p ratio 1.5 and above are radioactive, that they emit radiations. They are unstable elements, example heavy metals like uranium. You know the meaning of radioactive, students. There are certain elements who keep on emitting radiations from their nucleus. So these elements will be having the n upon p ratio somewhere equal to 1.5 or more than that.
So this is all for today. Goodbye.